Yo, what is up? Windmellow here. Today we're going over the patch notes 1.12 Monuments of Power. So in addition to this expansion, there is going to be one more expansion to follow in December with the scheduled release of the mini expansion. Then it will be complete. As mentioned before, we are going to get some seasonal tournaments. So those are going to be updated on October 15th. We're going to get some more info on that, which I feel like is good. We do know that they have said the competitive scene is starting at the end of 2020, as well as the beginning of 2021. So it's actually starting a little earlier than we thought. So I think that's good. Region road updates. So we got some more level extension. And now here's the meat and potatoes, the card updates. So they're changing their approach to live design and to promote metagame diversity and emphasis of buffs rather than nerfs. I actually really like this because it maintains a stability and has a different design philosophy that tries to put everything on its own pace. This is like what I said about Bilgewater, for example. Like, Bilgewater isn't the problem, it's other regions not having the cards to deal with Bilgewater that are on the same set as Bilgewater, as well as perhaps even right now Lee Sin, which I do not feel like is a problem as a card whatsoever. So I actually really like this design philosophy that the live design lead Ruben Zhu lays out for us here. This is going to actually start off with a few nerfs, but I feel like they are deserved with balancing the game, especially with all the new things that we are getting out, even if they are going towards a more buff oriented design. First off is a slight nerf to Genevieve Elmhart, which is now a 5-4 instead of a 5-5. With the fact that it had Scout as well as Challenge and when I'm summoned, give other allies +1/+1 this round, that was just way too many stats going on for that much. And I feel like just even putting it down to that 4 cost is really going to balance it out and make it easier to deal with rather than having this continual value with its trading Bastion. Alright, so Bastion is going to change to a 4 cost. It's a burst +1/+1 spell shield, which I still feel like is going to be so much better than what it was before. We definitely saw this coming. They talked about it on Twitter before. And again, this is just another response to perhaps like the Lee Sin decks. It's not Lee Sin that's a problem. It's these supporting cards that just need to be slightly changed so they aren't quite as effective. So this is going to be a lot more balanced, so you can't just have the three, you could play out all your mana and then have the three bangs for Bastion. And there's already a lot of other spell shield cards or buff cards that you're going to be able to have in Targon, and this just makes it slightly less in every single deck. But I still feel like we're still going to see this a lot. Next is the very controversial Hush. So with the design, they wanted to go and change it slightly last patch and then change it fully this. So this is going to be removing Hush's repeatable aspect while reducing its cost. So this is definitely not going to be a dead card. We're still going to see Hush. It's just having so you can't continuously Hush all the time and get so much value out of 1/3 cost card. Next is Living Legends. So originally it was fill your hand with ramp fleeing cards, refill your mana, and now it is fill your hand with ramp fleeing cards, refill your mana gems to full. So this is no longer going to go and refill your spell mana that you would have had with it, which makes it a lot better with more balance here, because by the time you get Living Legends, it's already going to get so much value out of this with both your spells or your celestial cards as well as your units. Next we have the lab. So this is just going to be the new labs that are going to go and focus on different sorts of landmarks. It seems like we're going to be switching labs on different weeks, which is pretty cool. So we're going to go and do a landmarkation first, and they're going to give you like pre-con decks, and then we're going to go back to ARAM with some changes, which I actually really like. I like the switching it up, bringing some things back just to experiment and make it a little spicy. Next is boards. It's a Halloween board for Halloween. You love to see it. I love it. So this is a pretty cool Halloween board. I don't think I'm going to be getting it myself, but It looks cool. I hope you get to interact with it because I love interactive boards. This is definitely a really adorable Infernal Drake. It's fitting with the Shyvana. So its favorite food is barbecue. Oh, that's so cute. But this Poro Boo is really cute. I actually may end up getting this. The dragon looks super cool, but I mean, nothing beats cute though. These are our new emotes in store. I think they look pretty cool, especially I really like Soraka. I feel like I could definitely replace the Soraka here with some of the, for example, the Darius emote. Like, I feel like her look of anguish in her eyes is great. This is this Tom Kent m'lady. Then we're of course getting the deck bundles. Depending on what is in the contents of this deck, we may or may not really need it unless you want the exclusives, because you do probably have Azul by now, but I don't know. I feel like it's a more aesthetically pleasing package than some of the other ones. Expeditions got upgraded, we do not care. And then for all of you people who got Masters last season and then haven't gotten back to Masters, well, I'm sorry, but for this patch, you're not gonna get back there because it's gonna be reset on October 15th. So if you are in Diamond and got Masters last time and really wanna still get your icon, do that today, because the ranked season is going to be going down tomorrow at 10 a.m. PT to 11 a.m. PT on October 14th. So you got no times. I'm totally not talking about myself. Let me know what you think about the changes of the card as well as the general card design direction that they are going in. I'm really curious.